thank you. Good evening. I fully agree with my colleague and those who are saying that the summit in Wales was important turning point for NATO. Will it deliver and ensure long-term security in Europe and protection of transatlantic interests globally? It has to be seen. I can say that since the beginning, our attention in Wales was to revitalize the bond between Europe and the United States. And previously, we had a feeling of growing differences in our priorities and underperformance of Europe when it comes to defense capabilities and political will. However, it seems that to a certain extent these differences were artificial, and the crisis in Ukraine returned us back to the situation where we naturally belong to. Since regaining independence for the Baltic states, it has been very clear that the transatlantic link and the US presence in the region are equally important for our security as our benefits provided by the European Union. During the NATO summit, we achieved several very positive things. From one side, it approved NATO member states' commitment to stop declining defense budgets and to revise the trend which aim to achieve 2% goal. The readiness action plan, which has been approved by the summit, eventually will raise the alliance readiness and ability to act not only to the response of changing Russia, but also emerging threat in the region. On the other side, the U.S. Has proven that it is serious about European security, and U.S. is back in Europe. And what is particularly important for us, it is U.S. is back in the Baltic states. Once again, I would like to stress the importance of pledge of 2% of defense spending at the summit. I am aware that there are some critics who say that it is not enough and progress should be more faster. In this regard, I would argue that most important thing is that all decisions, and particularly defense pledge, were made unanimously by all member states, by 28 democracies, not autocracies. I think it's that it's most important strength of NATO. For us, it's a problem that we had very different experience, and we had to learn from own mistakes, as our defense system was created from the scratch in 1991. And from one side, it is clear that defense capabilities cannot be created overnight. And from other side, it is important to spend money efficiently, as the trust of society depends on it. I can say that I certainly don't expect that NATO will be able to retire after Afghanistan and avoid all international problems. On the contrary, I can say, and I am convinced, that the need to use military force will only grow as more and more our interests might be challenged in the future. But simultaneously, it is clear that we will not be able to repeat neither Afghanistan nor Kosovo operation for many reasons. First of all, It is long and resource-consuming nation-building missions. And I believe that we should find less demanding exit strategies from this toolbox. And finally, I can say that crisis in Ukraine gave another positive impetus for solving a long-standing problem between NATO and EU, and the crisis has drawn natural boundaries or division of labor between these two organizations in crisis management that had tendency to duplicate previously. The response of North Atlantic Alliance has underscored its hard power capacity and deterrence potential, but the EU has demonstrated its powerful tool of soft power and financial mechanisms. Certainly, I think it gives us a very solid ground to develop and cement this complementary even further on, including cyber capabilities, strategic communications, and so on. Speaking about your question, it's this Riga test. I can say that no citizens of Riga can sleep safe. But of course, it is a lot of work to be done in order to give citizens of Riga the same assurance in long-term perspectives for 5, 10, 15 years. Firstly, I think we have to invest considerably more in our own defense and develop our capabilities. Secondly, we must implement the good decisions of the last NATO summit. And of course, finally, I can say that we we should not forget the events in Ukraine, that these events have changed considerably all European security system. And if we will ignore that, then not only citizens of Riga, but also of Berlin will not be safe anymore.